disposable respirator, we've been learning, is in short supply. And so the goal here was not to reinvent the wheel, but to source alternative media that could also satisfy the filtration requirements.
My name is Matt Carney, and welcome to my front porch. What we're trying to do right now is build a reusable N95 alternative mask. So that is a mask that is actually a respirator, so tight fitting, fits around your face, and can actually have all of the protections of an N95 mask. So that means it has a nice seal around your face, it is comfortable to wear for long periods of time, and it has a replaceable filter in it. So you can sterilize and reuse the mask portion, and then just swap out the filter as necessary. Fundamentally, we kind of approached this from a different point of view, which was we really wanted to build something that scales. And so we really wanted to leverage manufacturing processes that do scale. But also processes that you can rely on to go through regulatory processes. As soon as we started diving into this and really trying to understand what are the governmental rules for how to accomplish this, we realized that those safety rules are actually very hard to hit. Very early on, we started building prototypes that we were sending to get tested at a NIOSH facility that could test the breathability. So inhale, exhale, pressure drop or breathing resistance, as well as residual CO2. And that is that as you exhale, you breathe out a bunch of CO2. And if there's dead space between your face and the mask, when you re-inhale that, you're re-inhaling CO2. So you're not getting as much oxygen as you expect. And then there's some additional ASTM standards that are also testing particle filtration efficiencies. So what is the pressure drop as particles are passing through this filter? How many particles of what size diameter pass through the filter, as well as its ability to block bacteria passing through?
Running into all the scarcity and all the other issues is a major problem for us. So this project has been really, really good for us.
I've had multiple users wear them and run through some of the standard procedures, just job requirements that we would have with the other PPE that typically would go hand in hand with an N95. And I think it's really important that we in EMS and healthcare look at PPE that is affordable and reusable, and you know, that people feel comfortable wearing.
I really wanted to leverage mass manufacturing practices and come up with a design that could really take all this idle manufacturing that exists right now and turn it on to kind of broaden the actual supply chain of personal protective equipment. It's leveraging what we're good at the Media Lab, this desire to jump in and think a little differently about things and to build up a team to actually make things happen.